ESPN presents NCAA College Football. Division II playoff, the Northern Colorado Bears versus the Eastern Illinois Panthers. Brought to you by Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you.
Some 48 hours ago, better than a half foot of snow struck here in the Midwest. Struck here at Charleston, Illinois, the scene of today's Division II playoff game between Northern Colorado and the Panthers of Eastern Illinois. Now, as a consequence of that heavy downpour of snow, the playing conditions here at O'Brien Stadium are really less than ideal. Good afternoon, everybody. This is Bill O'Donnell together with Terry Hanratty. And Terry, before we talk about the football teams, we have to talk about the condition of the playing field here at O'Brien Stadium. How bad is it? How playable is it?
Well, Bill, yesterday they had a lot of ice on the field. So they turned their sprinkler system on to try to melt the ice, but it ends up in a quagmire. But the thing is, I've talked to a lot of people, and everyone thinks that it's going to be to the advantage of Northern Colorado because they run the ball an awful lot. But it's really tough to get a running game on track in muddy weather. Eastern Illinois is a throwing team, and they're going to get back in that shotgun, and they're going to throw the ball. And when it's bad weather, the offense always has the advantage because they know where the receivers are going to go. And a slip by a defensive back is an easy touchdown, so the advantage goes to a passing game.
So the biggest pressure, perhaps, in this ball game today, the biggest pressure, because of the condition of the playing field, could well be on the cornerbacks and the deep safety people.
Oh, it really is. Number one, because it's tough to get a pass rush when you can't get footing. And the defensive backs are going to sit back there. If they make one slip, it's all over.
Now, the condition of the playing field, again, is far from ideal, but the weather is ideal, at least the weather above the field. Clear skies, a crisp afternoon fall day here in Charleston, Illinois, as we get ready for Northern Colorado and Eastern Illinois in their Division II playoff game. And we'll be right back after this message.
This Bud's for everybody who puts in a hard day's work.
This Bud's for you, for all you do. The king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you, that distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do.
This Bud's for you.
Have a pencil? I'm going to give you the name of a publication that is read regularly by thousands of professional investors. Professionals whose careers depend on their making smart decisions every day. Ready? The publication is Barron's, published by Dow Jones. Professionals read Barron's because every week it gives them accurate and complete investment information. Hard, useful investment facts. Because Barron's has a proven track record in analyzing trends and upcoming market developments. You can get Barron's too. If you call this number now, you can get a 13-week subscription for only $12, and you'll get this booklet free, Understanding Technical Forecasting, that tells you in plain English just how professionals use Barron's, how you can use Barron's. 13 weeks of Barron's plus this revealing booklet for only $12. Professionals who have to be right read it. Maybe you should, too. Call now toll-free 800-528-6050. That's 800-528-6050.
ESPN, the network that brought you 22 National Collegiate Basketball Championship games last year, is back with the biggest and best schedule of college hoops anywhere. Teams like Louisville, Kentucky, DePaul, conferences like the ACC, the Big East, and the Pac-10. Which budding stars will fill the shoes of last year's All-Americans? Stay with ESPN. NCAA Soccer on ESPN, the Division II Championship, Monday, December 8, 8 p.m. Eastern Time, on your Total Sports Network.
Well, both these teams are representing their respective conferences today, Northern Colorado and Eastern Illinois, not just with great seasons, but also with championship seasons within their conference. In terms of Northern Colorado, 7-3 on the year, 6-1 on the season to win the North Central Conference, followed by Nebraska, Oklahoma, North Dakota, and North Dakota State all at 5-2, and then to bring up the rear, South Dakota, Augustana, South Dakota State, and Morganside without a victory in the conference standings. Now, Eastern Illinois on the year had a record overall both within and outside the conference of 9-2. Won the conference without a defeat, 4-0, followed by a real good team, Northern Michigan, and then the rest of the Mid-Central Conference, Northern Iowa, Youngstown State, and Western Illinois did not win a conference game. Now, one of the features of the ball game this afternoon, Terry and I have both chatted about the fine passing game of Eastern Illinois. Eastern Illinois has not just one good quarterback, has two very good quarterbacks, and Terry Hanratty has chatted with each one.
Eastern Illinois today, two quarterbacks you're going to see all day long. Number 14, Chuck Wright, and number 11, Jeff Christensen. Guys, you know, I can sympathize with both of you. Being with Pittsburgh the first 3 or 4 years, Terry Bradshaw and myself going back and forth. I'm playing one play, he's playing the other. What's your feelings about that?
I don't know. Just, you know, coaches feel that Jeff needs to come in or I need to come in. It, you know, just really up to them. It's, you know, it's the best thing for the team. It's the best thing, for, you know, to win.
What do you think, Jeff?
Well, we're winning a lot of ball games, so I don't know that whatever they're doing something right. So it's been kind of shaky at times, but we've just learned to accept it. And when you're asked to play, you play. And when you sit and watch, you try to sit and read defenses. When you're on the sidelines, when you go in, that way you know what you're doing.
No, the real big thing about it is that knowing that you're going to play is that you stay loose on the sidelines.
Oh yeah, yeah. I warm up a lot, and then when I go in, Chuck comes out. He warms up a lot, and that way you never, whenever you're asked, you know, Coach Shaw, he asks you. On a spur of a moment, he might not even warn you sometimes. So,
Chuck, you're with a passing offense. It's got to be exciting.
Yeah, for sure. I love the pass ball. I was here a couple years ago when they were running all the time, and I didn't get a whole lot of playing time then. And then when Coach Muter came, he put the new offense in, and I got to play a little bit more.
How about the field conditions today? It's not great out there, to say the least. Do you think it favors the passing or the running?
I don't know. Either way, you can look at it. You know, it can favor either way. We know where we're going, and they don't. And the running game, you know, you push people off the line and run. So, I don't know, either way, you just have to go out and see, I guess.
Jeff, you're number one team in the country. Think there's a little pressure on you today?
Not at all. No way at all. We're number one. They got to beat us. We just got to be ourselves and play our ball game. If we do that, well, I think we'll come out on top.
You know, in terms of both these competing coaches today, each one is kind of a veteran. If not perhaps a veteran coach at his own school, then a longtime veteran in terms of college football. And we had the pleasure moments ago to chat with each one of these great coaches. Coach Muter of Eastern Illinois and Coach Blasey of Northern Colorado. Most of the hype around college football, I think you would agree, is built around the Division I teams as opposed to the Division II schools like your own. So we'd like to give you this opportunity for your big equal time. How proud are you of your football team?
Well, I think the same kinds of things happen to our players that happened to the players at Ohio State and Michigan. They're going to look back on this experience as one of the high points in their life, and it's just as meaningful and just as important to each one of our players as it is to a player that plays in the Big Ten. And it won't make, in 20 years, it won't make a heck of a lot of difference. But we think that our program has... you know, is important in the life of the, in the education of the boy that's here at the university, and it's just an important part of his school experience, and it's just as valuable to him as it is to any one of the big schools.
Coach Blazer, you've spent an awful long time both as an assistant and as a head coach of Northern Colorado. This has been your best year?
Well, I think it's certainly been one of our best years. We've had better records before this, but I think this is one of the tougher schedules that we've played, and to have this kind of a record against this kind of a schedule, I think I'd have to say that, yes, our effort was there, and I think probably it is one of our better football teams.
Coach, there is a cliche, but many people believe it, that a weather-beaten field does at times tend to be an equalizer. Is that so here today?
Well, I think that's certainly a possibility that this game could be decided on breaks, fumbles, drop balls, slips, that type of thing. It just remains to be seen, actually.
Coach Muter, from the standpoint of a ball team that's known better for its passing game, your team, than a running game. Would you rather see this field better than it is today?
Oh, I think you always want the best conditions that you can get to play a game. I don't know if they will favor either team today. I think maybe Bob's right in that maybe there'll be a few more fumbles and a few more mistakes, a few more slips and things of that sort, and maybe the kicking game will be a little bit more of a factor. But, no, I'd prefer to have it a good day and so that we could maybe have a little bit better football game from the standpoint of the spectator and maybe give a little bit better performance.
Well, you know, moments ago you saw Terry Hanratty chat with Eastern Illinois' 1-2 passing punch, in that they have not just one good quarterback, but two good quarterbacks and both pretty fair passers. On the other hand, Northern Colorado has a 1-2 punch, a 1-2 running punch, and here's Terry to chat with part of that 1-2 running punch.
With me, sophomore tailback from Northern Colorado, Jim Bright. Jim, you guys are ranked number 8th in the country in Division II. Today you're playing the number 1 team in the country. What's the feeling of the team?
The feeling of the team is we're really happy to have the chance to play the number 1 team in the country. Feel lucky to get in the playoffs, and no matter what the condition, we're going to give it our best shot.
You're not, you're more of a running team. Today you're going against a passing team. The conditions on the field here are not fantastic. You think that's in your favor?
I think it will be, because I think the stronger type running back, the conditions will favor that. It's going to come down to the offensive lineman who does the job, and I think ours will do the job.
What kind of running scheme? You are a running team. There's a lot of, you know, there's different running type offenses where you trap and finesse block. You guys more a power offense or a finesse offense?
More of a power offense. We're in a lot of off-tackle plays and a lot of play-action passing.
Okay, today you share time with Chris Copa, who you two are very close. I mean, it's tough to get two tailbacks in the same offense. Do you think it hinders your play or his play, or how do you feel about that?
I think both of us should be better off with more time, but I think, you know, I'm happy with the situation, and I know Chris is, and he's playing well, and he deserves a chance.
And this is the scene on the campus of Eastern Illinois University here in Charleston, Illinois, just south of the city of Chicago. The weather conditions ideal, but the condition of the playing field not ideal. Now, Terry Hanratty, you've been asking a lot of questions of many people today. A question of Terry Hanratty from yours truly, Bill O'Donnell. On a field like this, a muddy field, a slick field, and not a good playing field, do you personally like a passing game today? Do you like a running game better today?
Most people, Bill, would say the running game, but I have to go completely opposite. I have to like the passing game because your receivers know where they're going to go. It's tough to put a pass rush on because they really can't get the footing. And I think they're going to sit back in that shotgun. I'll tell you what, it's going to be tough to get to them.
So it's a Division II playoff game today between a pair of conference winners, the Bears of Northern Colorado against the Panthers of Eastern Illinois. Back with the kickoff after this.
Somewhere in these Chiricahua Hills, no white man will ever know where, the Apaches buried Cochise, the greatest of their great chiefs. Geronimo faded into these hills, and it took 5,000 U.S. soldiers to bring him out. And now Time Life Books brings the great chiefs to life again as your introductory volume to a fast-writing series called The Old West. Hundreds of authentic pictures give you the real story. For the first time ever, you'll be able to see Geronimo's combat dagger and Colt 45. You'll look into the eyes of Sitting Bull, the man who destroyed Custer. Quanah Parker, the fierce Comanche whose mother was a captured farm girl, and all the great chiefs. Eyewitness accounts and rare photographs and art bring the Old West to life. You'll meet the gunfighters. Men like John Wesley Hardin, so mean he once shot a man just for snoring. The cowboys, blazed in glory by the greatest artists of the Old West. The pioneers, battling the savage elements and bloodthirsty war parties. The gamblers, the women of the West. They're all here in big, handsome books with the look and feel of hand-tooled saddle leather. We'll send you the great chiefs for a 10-day examination. If you're not impressed, just return it within 10 days and pay nothing. If you decide to keep the great chiefs, you pay just $12.95 plus shipping and handling.
Then approximately every other month, we'll send you another lively volume from the Old West Library for a 10-day examination. Keep only the volumes you want. You can cancel at any time. Here's how to order.
Phone toll-free 800-228-2070 or write Great Chiefs, 815 Time and Life Building, Chicago. We'll send qualified buyers a volume for 10 days with no obligation to buy. So write Great Chiefs, 815 Time and Life Building, Chicago, or phone toll-free 800-228-2070.
And Terry Hanratty getting ready with you now for the playoff game, a Division II playoff game between Northern Colorado and Eastern Illinois. Northern Colorado attired in white with black and gold trim. Northern Colorado defending the goal to our right will do the kicking off. And the deep man awaiting the Eastern Illinois kickoff is Kevin Staple, number 8. He's standing just inside the 5-yard line. And kicking off for Northern Colorado is Kevin Jeldon. And we're underway. A low end-over-end kick taken back at the 12-yard line and brought back near the 25-yard line, where it will be Eastern Illinois ball. Kevin Marlott came down to make the grab on the man who returned the kickoff. All right, Eastern Illinois' offensive line, Dobrich at one tackle, to Davenport at the other, and their tight end, Mahalik. So it's Eastern Illinois ball now to start play from the 26-yard line. And number 14, Chuck Wright, is the starting quarterback. All right, over left tackle goes number 45, Rod Slaughter. And Slaughter does not approach and get to the 30-yard line. He is a bit short after a 4-yard gain, and he's grabbed by the linebacker, number 88, Bob Napton. So it's a gain of 4 by Slaughter, the fullback. And here's the Northern Colorado defensive line end-to-end. The middle guard, by the way, Volkert's a pretty good one. And here's the deep secondary, which will be under some kind of pressure because of the slick field. It is a second down and 6. And it's intercepted out on the flat by Nosler, defensive end, and Nosler for a touchdown. Deacon Nosler, a defensive end from Omaha, Nebraska. Surprisingly, quickly, and practically out of nowhere, gives Northern Colorado a 6-0 lead.
Bill, good theory here by Eastern Illinois, but what Wright has to do, he has to get it over. They're just, it's like an option play. You got to get it over Nosler's head, though. You see, he had a little clear running room, but it's a touch pass. You got to throw it just a little higher. And what a way to start out the ball game here, second play.
Deacon Nosler makes it Northern Colorado 6, Eastern Illinois 0. And now the extra point attempt by Kevin Jeldon to try to give the Bears a very early 7-0 lead. They have the go-ahead touchdown after only 44 seconds. The extra point try is indeed good. So Northern Colorado, with an intercepted pass, runs some 25 yards by the young man from Omaha, Nebraska, Deacon Nosler, a 215-pound junior. And then the extra point makes it 7-0, and it's only 44 seconds into the opening period.
Hey, Bill, we knew we were going to have a lot of scoring today, but never thought it would come that quick. Let's take another look at Nosler here. What Wright has to do, he has to get a little deeper and let the linebackers get a little further in their drop. Here, Nosler just sitting right out in the flat, and Wright just threw it right into his hand. You see it here. It's a good one-handed catch, but I'll tell you, you just got to let these people, you know, have to let the play develop a little more. That time, he was just a little rushed and throwing the ball.
Well, it wasn't too long ago that Northern Colorado had the opening kickoff, and little did it figure some 44 seconds ago that it would be ahead this quickly. But indeed, the visiting Bears from Greeley, Colorado are ahead, and Northern Colorado's Kevin Jeldon will kick off again. Jeldon's been a busy guy the first minute into this football game, a kickoff, an extra point, and now another kickoff by Jeldon. And awaiting the kickoff, here he is again, Kevin Staple, standing back near the 5-yard line. Now, Staple has returned a kickoff this year, 80 yards against Southern Illinois. And it's towards Staple this time, over his head and over the end line, and the touchback will give Eastern Illinois the ball again. But this time, not at the 26-yard line where it began after the first kickoff, but this time from the Panther 20-yard line. Again, Northern Colorado
has yet to have its offense handle the ball, but is nonetheless leading by a score of 7-0. Eastern Illinois has won its last 8 games. It won overall 9 of 11 this year, and in 9 of the 11 scored better than 30 points. Straight back is Wright. Throws a screen out on the flat to number 45, Slaughter, and he's all the way to the 29 or 30 yard line, where the hit is applied by Todd Volkert, the middle guard. So Wright, who threw 14 touchdown passes, hitting his man Slaughter, and they're going to mark the ball at the 30 yard line for a first down. First and 10 on this slippery field. That's Wright's season stat. He threw 14 touchdown passes. The other quarterback, Christensen, fired 13. 49 Bill. All right, the backs very widely split from one side to the other. Sweeping the left side is Staple, and he'll get no yardage at all. Staple could not turn the left corner, and the reaction was made by Bob Napton, number 88, a junior out of Yuma, Colorado. Bob Napton. Napton led Northern Colorado in tackles during this current campaign with close to 200. Second down, Eastern Illinois. Second down and 10. Now Wright has his back split widely again, and he has a wide flanker out to the right side. It is Staple straight ahead. Staple crashing from the line of scrimmage at the 30 and approaching the 33-yard line after a 3-yard gain. Napton, a busy guy. Napton, 88 there again for the Northern Colorado tackle.
Bill, might add here that Eastern Illinois has only 5 running plays. They got a sweep, a couple draws, and the little trap we just saw up the middle there. So they are a passing team. They only have 5 running plays in their whole offense.
Scott McGee, number 25, out very wide to the right side. Third down, 7 at the East Illinois 33. Wright with some time. Down the middle, it's caught at the 45. To the 50, goes McGee. He's to the 40, and he's down in Northern Colorado territory at the 38-yard line. The gain is close to 30 yards, and the cornerback came up to make the grab, Tom Covington.
Say one thing about Chuck Wright, he did not let that interception concern him at all, because this is one of the tougher throws to, one of the deadliest throws as far as the defense is concerned, because he's thrown right over the middle. You see right in between the coverage, the safety man in the corner. And you see Scott McGee made a nice reception and a good gainer for him.
At the Northern Colorado 38-yard line now, the deep back Staple, about a yard. All he could get to was the 37-yard line, and Todd Volkert got to him very quickly also. Volkert, number 90, a senior middle guard out of Wahoo, Nebraska. So it's second down, 9. Northern Colorado is leading by a score of 7-0. But this Eastern Illinois bunch here is on the move. It has come from its 20. It is now second down at the Northern Colorado 37. Second down and 9. Ball is equidistant between the 2 sidelines. On the delay, Slaughter. And Slaughter to the 30 and keeps on banging. He bangs his way as far as the 26-yard line. Rod Slaughter, a 210-pound senior, drives his way for a first down.
And Bill, when you're a passing team, one of the most effective plays you can do is run the draw, because you keep that defense alert. They're looking for you to throw the ball here. Now Rod Slaughter, that's that little sprint draw that Eastern Illinois has.
Otis Grant is out wide to the left. And Scott McGee, 25, is to this side of the field. First down at the 26-yard line at the Northern Colorado 26. And Wright in a mood to throw again. To the far sideline, he overthrows number 45, and he overthrows his fullback, Rod Slaughter. Out in the flat, McLaren, the defensive end, went out with the intended receiver on that first down pass. So here's the 8th play coming up in this Eastern Illinois drive. It all began back at the 20 after a Nosler interception of a right pass on the extra point has given Northern Colorado an early lead. Second down, 10 at the Northern Colorado 26. We have played 4 minutes of the first quarter. Wright with loads of time again. A man free, it's Slaughter, the fullback. Hit immediately at the 15-yard line, and it should be a first down. Slaughter ran two plays ago for 11. Now takes a forward pass fired strong by Wright, and then he gets knocked down by Ray Sperger, the deep safety man.
Bill, I think we're seeing now what we mentioned at the top of the show is it's very tough in these playing conditions to get any rush on the quarterback. And that time, Wright had an awful lot of time, you know, just sitting back here maybe three, 4.5 seconds, something like that.
All right, four first downs in this pretty good Eastern Illinois drive. Wright is still the quarterback. He's been a master of this Panther drive. Open field is to the quarterback's right. He goes to Slaughter, the fullback, and Slaughter can only pick up about 1 yard on the slippery turf. And then Deacon Nosler handled him for keeps near the 14-yard line.
Flag gain on the play. Second and 9 for Eastern.
The ball is just a little bit inside the 14-yard line. Right now, it is fairly easy to pick out the yard lines on the field. But as we get a little bit further along today, it might not be quite as easy. Grant flanked to the short side. That's to the left. McGee flanked to the wide side, out here to the right. Second down and 9. Right back near the 23-yard line. Throws to the inside.
Touchdown.
Touchdown. And he throws it to Scott McGee. McGee, who made 16 touchdown catches, makes a touchdown catch in this game. It's now 7-6.
The thing that really made that play was, again, the amount of time that Wright had in the backfield. He's taking about 4 seconds back there sitting out there, and it's, you know, he's an effective passer, so it's really tough to to let a kid like him sit back there and just pick out the pass.
All right, it's an 80-yard drive on the 10th play. The extra point attempt by DeLong ties the game. It is now Eastern Illinois 7, Northern Colorado 7, and the Northern Colorado offense now will be coming on the field actually for the first time in this game. Well, that's an unusual way to get the crowd alive, a cement truck.
I've never seen it before.
Not for the purpose that you might think.
We thought maybe they put that on the field to soak up some of the mud out there. Making an AstroTurf real quick.
Ray DeLong will do the kicking off now for Eastern Illinois. And moving back deep for Northern Colorado is Donnie James. James will stand just inside the Northern Colorado 5-yard line. So we got a pretty good ball game, haven't we, Terry, for the first 5 minutes and 8 seconds. Both teams have scored. Each has scored in a different way. A go-ahead TD by the visiting Bears of Northern Colorado with the intercepted pass.
And, Bill, that was an awful impressive drive. 10 plays, 80 yards, and eight up 4 minutes and 24 seconds. And that shows how effective they are in the passing game. You do what you do best, and that's what Eastern Illinois throws the ball, so just come out there winging it.
All right, the kickoff by DeLong of Eastern Illinois. He's just going to tee it up a little bit better. He wasn't quite too comfortable with the way the ball was teed up. All right, the DeLong kickoff for Eastern Illinois. Not deep.
It travels hits him in the head.
15-yard line. And Northern Colorado touched it, but I think the Bears have made the recovery. They have recovered that errant kickoff, which hit one of the up men.
The old line hit him. He was using his head on that play, right, Bill?
Mm-hmm. Northern Colorado will set up shop at the 22-yard line. 80-yard drive, an 80-yard drive, 10 plays. Took a little bit more than 4 minutes. We have 9 minutes and 50 seconds to play in the first quarter. Winslow, number 11, is the quarterback. His two running backs, Bixler, 35, the fullback and the up man, and Copa, 22, is the deep man. Here's Copa, a freshman, to the 25, stopped at the 26-yard line. Copa gallops his way, out slightly to the left side for 4 yards.
Northern Colorado is a running offense, but I'll tell you what, I saw Winslow warming up here, and he has a fine arm on him, so I wouldn't be a bit surprised if we saw a little more passing by him this today.
All right, second down and 6 from the 26. Winslow good enough to make second team all-conference. 87 Lindsay out to the open field. He's out to the right. The motion man is Sage. Copa over right tackle. Doesn't get far at all. In fact, the hold is closed right about at the line of scrimmage. Charlie Kretzinger was one of the first Eastern Illinois football players to get there. It's third down now and six. Jaeger out to the left. Right, let's see if Winslow, deep in his own territory now, is going to put the ball in the air. Third and six from the 26. He slipped. He has fumbled. And Eastern Illinois has recovered inside the 15-yard line. It looked like number 86, Wanowski, made the recovery. The quarterback going straight back, and then Winslow on the slippery turf fumbles, and it's been recovered by Eastern Illinois.
I see a big break. The interception for the touchdown for Northern Colorado early on the first drive. Now the big fumble recovery here.
Eastern Illinois at the Northern Colorado 14-yard line in a 7-7 tie. Staple to the 10. Staple keeps going, and he's to the 8-yard line for a pickup of 6 yards. Todd Volkert was there to trap him. The Staple is not too big. The freshman is only 5'8", and he scales around 170 pounds, but he hits straight ahead pretty strong for a little guy. 6 yards to the 8-yard line. 8 yards for a go-ahead touchdown required. 4 yards needed for a first down. Just under 8 minutes to play in the first quarter. Score tied, 7 apiece. It is Slaughter to the 5-yard line. Slaughter picks up 3 yards. He's a yard short of a first down, and Deacon Nosler, who has played well on defense in the early going, was there on the hit for Northern Colorado. Third down and one at the Northern Colorado 5. The Bears from Greeley, Colorado had the early advantage, 7-0. It is now a 7-7 tie with Eastern Illinois threatening to go ahead. Third down, one at the 5. To the 2-yard line. To the 2-yard line goes number 31, and that is Lauren Baker.
I tell you, Bill, it's such a luxury to be in the position to get a first down inside the 5-yard line, because that really opens up what you can do offensively.
First and goal now for Eastern Illinois. Ball is at the 1-yard line, so they've got 4 cracks. They've got that full house backfield now right behind the quarterback right. Baker. Baker hitting straight ahead, and no arms have been raised as yet. The ball now is just inside the 1-yard line. Second down, less than a yard for a go-ahead TD. 8 minutes, 20 seconds to play, first quarter. 7-7. Tight end right, Mahalik. Tight end left, McGee.
Mix up
Baker with a marker drop. There was a mix-up with a handoff, and with a penalty marker down, Baker gets upset a good 3 yards behind the line of scrimmage by Deacon Nosler again.
I think we're going to see Northern Colorado jumping off the ball just a little too quick here. Let's see the action there. Looks like the left defensive end lined up offside, and there's a sheer mix-up in the backfield.
Well, if it is against Northern Colorado, of course, that'll turn out to be a fantastic break for Eastern Illinois. Offside, Northern Colorado. So they'll step it off half the distance to the goal line, and naturally the down remains the same. Second down, still goal to go, and less than a yard with that full house backfield directly behind the senior quarterback, number 14, Chuck Wright. Does he go to Baker again? He does! And Baker hitting over the left side. I don't think he has broken the plane of the goal line. Bob Napton reacted to on number 88.
And it's a definite advantage when you're trying to run that ball in this mud for the defense, because all these guys have to do is really bury. It's tough to do any trap blocking. You try to blow them out, and all they just have to do is sit there, and that's exactly what they did that time. So I'd be shocked if Eastern Illinois does not try to do something wide here.
Third down, goal to go. All right, Baker in the middle. Slaughter to his left and Staple to his right. No, sir. No, sir. Driven back was Tyrone Davis. He was trying to leap over some blockers ahead of him, but couldn't get anywhere near beyond them.
And I'll tell you, the surge of that defense, I'll tell you what, it's tough to run it up the middle. You got to do something wide here. Try to get your quarterback, even though Wright is not a runner. Try to get him outside. You see the contact right there. I mean, it's great pursuit by the linebackers and safety men.
All right, fourth down at the one-yard line, and still goal to go. Northern Colorado playing real tough on the inside running. Middle man in the full house backfield is Davis. To his right is Baker. It is a touchdown scored by Tyrone Davis, a freshman. That makes it Eastern Illinois 13, Northern Colorado 7. The go-ahead touchdown for the Panthers comes after 10 minutes and 45 seconds of the opening period.
It's an exciting crew there, the cheerleaders.
So we've had a turnover backfire against each team. An intercepted pass backfired against Eastern Illinois, and then a fumble by Northern Colorado backfiring against the Bears. It is now 13-7, Eastern Illinois. The extra point try by DeLong, and now it's good. It is now Eastern Illinois 14, Northern Colorado 7.
Yeah, I mentioned it's tough to go up the middle. So, you know, try to either go off tackle or to the outside. This time they ran Davis to the right off tackle, and there was nobody there. See, they're all filling. When you get down this close, the defense really has to guess, because 1 yard, you really can't use finesse. And they guessed wrong that time. They tried to plug up the middle again.
Terry Hanratty, I'm sure you realize that here in the first quarter, which is now approaching the late stages of the opening period, that the Northern Colorado offensive team has only had its hands on the ball for 3 plays. And that third and last play was the fumble by the quarterback, Winslow, and then the ensuing recovery by Eastern Illinois, and now they've got a go-ahead touchdown. They go 14 yards, and our book has them going those 14 yards in 7 plays. Ray DeLong to kick off, and Donnie James of Northern Colorado stands right outside the goal line. There is a pretty good wind now whipping through O'Brien Stadium, and it is in the face of the kickoff man, DeLong. The Eastern Illinois kickoff, and it's low and not good again, rolls around the 18-yard line and is going to be brought back. Brought back by Chris Copa, the freshman running back. So fairly decent field position now for the Bears of Northern Colorado.
There you see Chris Copa shaking off that mud.
All right, 15 yards, the length of the drive, 8 plays, and Davis from the 1 yard line for the go-ahead touchdown. Northern Colorado from its 25. Here is Copa, and immediately grabbed at the line of scrimmage. Copa really got whacked at the line of scrimmage by number 66, Charlie Krutzinger. No gain on the play. Second down and 10.
Hey, Bill, Northern Colorado has to try to loosen him up here. He wins to let him throw that ball a little bit.
All right, Lindsay is out to the left. 360. All right, it is the fullback slamming straight ahead. It is Brad Bixler out of Lakewood, Colorado, and he doesn't have too much territory either. There to haul him down was Ira Jefferson, the linebacker, number 46. The gain is only 1 yard. So it's third down and 9 at the 26-yard line. One thing, of course, that the officials are doing constantly is trying to keep a dry ball in the game as often as possible. 21, Yeager, out to this side of the field. 39, Northern Colorado at its 26. Trailing right now, 14-7. Winslow's got it himself, and Winslow can't go anywhere. All right, it'll be Northern Colorado now in punt formation. They'll bring on Tony Davis, who was averaging just under 37 a kick this year. Kevin Gray is back at the Eastern Illinois 42-yard line. So if all things go systematically here, Eastern Illinois will wind up with pretty good field position. Northern Colorado, before the punt by Tony Davis, has called a timeout. Well, for the second year in a row, ESPN has already started to present its fine coverage of outstanding NCAA basketball. And among the early games to be carried by ESPN all around the country is the Stanford at Marquette game. That'll be Sunday night, December the 7th, to be programmed at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Of course, Marquette, under one of the fine veteran coaches in the country, Hank Raymond's. It also has on its ball team this year one of the more highly recruited freshman basketball players in the country, young fellow by the name of Glenn Rivers, and it has a pretty good shooter back from Raymond's team of a year ago, Oliver Lee. That's Sunday night, December the 7th at 8 o'clock, Stanford playing in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, against that Marquette team.
I tell you, it is tough to win in Marquette.
How about Green Bay? Was Green Bay tough to win at also?
When I first started in the pros, it was tough for us to win anywhere.
Because of the team or because of Hanratty?
Little both.
All right, Tony Davis stands back at his 5-yard line. And Gray waits at the Eastern Illinois 42. Pretty good
Whoa.
Rush on. And Gray from his own 40. Up the middle to the 45 and a 6-yard return. And Eastern Illinois finds itself at its 46-yard line. The tackler for Northern Colorado, number 44, Rob Capriolio.
I'll tell you, it was a shaky kick here because I thought there was going to be some roughing the kicker call. He waits a little long. Let's let Rush get in here. I'll tell you what, he took quite a shot and the official standing right there.
46-yard line for East Illinois, ahead 14-7. 2:13 left first quarter. A Division II playoff game here at Charleston, Illinois, the campus of the Eastern Illinois Panthers. Right back near the 35, a man free, and catching it at the 50-yard line was Rob Mihalik, the tight end. Mihalik goes as far as the Northern Colorado 46-yard line. The gain is about 8 or 9 yards. And Bob Napton was on the Northern Colorado tackle.
One thing about Eastern Illinois is they move that ball around. There's not any one receiver that's really a dominating factor on their team. They throw to their wide receivers, they throw to their backs. Now you see Mihalik make a nice catch. You can credit that to Dennis Shaw, the former All-American on the West Coast. What school did he go to, Bill?
San Diego State.
San Diego State, a former NFLer.
All right, second down and 1. Wright's going to throw deep.
Interference.
It's going to be pass interference near the 25-yard line against Tony Davis. It looked like Davis might have tripped the receiver.
Good call by the guys in white and black. Much, now you're going to see Davis come into the screen here, and that ball is still in the air. You can't touch that receiver. He makes the contact right there. Good call.
First down, Eastern Illinois at the Northern Colorado 23-yard line. Scott McGee out to the left side. Open field is out that way also. Delay handoff to Slaughter, and Slaughter drives his way to the 22-yard line. He can only pick up 1 yard. The tackle made by number 90, Todd Volkert.
That's one thing we'll see Eastern Illinois do today. When they run the ball, they're going to have two draws. They have a trap up the middle, and they sweep either way. And that's all you'll see. Other times, they'll just put the ball in the air.
Second down, 9 at the Northern Colorado 22. Out to the left goes Scott McGee. To this side is Otis Graham. Right back at the 30, and hits his man when he drops it at the 15-yard line. Dropping the ball, number 81, Rob Mihalik.
I'll tell you, Mihalik knew how wide open he was there, and that was going to be a big gainer. He may have even taken it in the end zone if he catches it.
So there is a 3rd and 9 coming up. Mihalik, 3 years in a row, has been a big contributor at tight end, and he still has one more season to go here at Eastern Illinois. 41 seconds to play in the first quarter. Eastern Illinois did trail early, 7-0. It's ahead 14-7 and might make it more. Third down, 9. Right from the 30. And it's completed the 16-yard line. And I don't think it's going to be enough for first down, despite a pretty good catch by Mihalik again, the tight end.
Let's take a look at right here. It's just a straight drop back. What they're doing, they're delaying their tight end on the right. You see Mihalik right at the middle of the screen right now. All right, all he does is a little drag. He lets that defense get deep, and Mihalik makes a nice catch here. Ball thrown a little bit behind him.
Fourth down and 1 coming up.
Mihalik's numbers for the day, 2 catches, 18 yards.
All right, only a yard for a first down. Last play of the quarter coming up. Wright's in trouble, but he finds his man Slaughter inside the 10-yard line. Slaughter, the fullback, and that's the final play of the first quarter.
And it shows you the real poise that Wright has in the backfield. There's 2 guys back here putting an awful lot of pressure on him. He doesn't really concern himself with it because he knows his receiver's coming open. Just give me another extra second, guys. And just a nice throw for the first down.
All right, that catch right there by the senior fullback, Rod Slaughter, closes out a pretty good first period. It is Eastern Illinois, 14, Northern Colorado, 7.
Billions of dollars are spent each year for research and development at our nation's institutions of higher education. These dollars are devoted to pursuing answers to the complicated questions that confront us today. In the process, they provide educational opportunities and exciting career possibilities. At Texas A&M University, research is being conducted with sorghum and sugarcane plants to develop a higher efficiency crop. Researchers are seeking better ways to use the entire plant. Stalks have the potential to be converted into sugar and molasses for animal feed, fermentation for energy, grain for human consumption, and the stalk residue may even be usable in the production of fiberboard and paper. In a project sponsored by the U.S. Department of Energy, scientists at the University of Tennessee Transportation Center are experimenting with a fleet of 15 electric cars. These researchers believe electric cars can outperform gas-operated vehicles and are a better alternative for family transportation and delivery services in urban areas. These electric cars not only consume less energy, but they also reduce noise and air pollution. Higher education is making a significant contribution to the betterment of people and the environment. It provides an expanding source of knowledge, inspiration, and hope for the future. Higher education, people preparing for tomorrow's challenge.
The top teams in the NHL on ESPN.
Since the early interception of the ball game by Northern Colorado defensive end Deacon Nosler, who ran the interception for a touchdown, since that play by Northern Colorado on defense, Eastern Illinois has dominated the football game, dominated enough to lead 14-7 at the end of the first period.
little child overseas is waiting for someone who cares. And you can be that special someone who offers her a better life, a life of hope. Call Foster Parents Plan, toll free, 800-621-5800. But please call soon, because a needy child can't wait forever.
Sports, all sports, and nothing but sports, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. ESPN, your total sports network, brings you the very best in sports programming and the latest scores, news, views, and interviews on SportsCenter, the most comprehensive sports news program on television. Your ticket to total sports is ESPN.
All right, back at Charleston, Illinois. This is the campus of Eastern Illinois University. Bill O'Donnell and Terry Hanratty beside me. Delighted to be joining with you for ESPN's coverage of this NCAA Division II playoff game between the Bears of visiting Northern Colorado and the host team, Eastern Illinois. Eastern Illinois knocking again, Terry, on touchdown's door, first and goal at the 7.
And you're getting a good look right now of just how much snow that fell here. I mean, I think they did a great job just to get the field in this good a condition.
Now, it will be interesting to see, and back to, we've now found out, we were wondering if Eastern Illinois coach Darryl Mudra would go with his alternating quarterback, Jeff Christensen, but he doesn't want to break up a good act right now. He's going to keep Chuck Wright in the ballgame.
And I'm a little surprised, Bill, because talking with Dennis Shaw, their offensive coordinator here, and there's Wright's stats for the day, seven completions, 10 attempts, one intercept, the big one, and right in the first drive for the touchdown. But I thought Christensen would be in here because they just alternate these guys back and forth. I mean, they are so close in their stats, it's hard to believe.
Again, between the two of them, they have fired in their 11-game season 27 touchdown passes. Wright, 14 touchdown passes. Christensen, a sophomore, 13 touchdown passes. All right, second quarter underway. Goal to go, first down at the Northern Colorado 7-yard line. Staple to the 5, keeps going, and he's got a touchdown, I think. Well, I guess he's a little bit short. Staple to the 1-yard line.
That time, I think that's the best surge that Eastern Illinois had running the ball. They just blew out Northern Colorado on that one side.
The fellow you just saw carry, Kevin Staple, a freshman, a light fellow, only 170-pounder, led Eastern Illinois in rushing this past season. He had 3 games of better than 100 yards. Goal to go on second down at the Northern Colorado 1. Full house backfield.
Whoa!
Oh, man alive, was Tyrone Davis cut apart. He was cut apart by the right safety man, Sean Pinon, number 41.
I'll tell you, this is great. Watch Pinon come in here, number 41. You're going to see it now. It looks like he's going to go in the end zone, but watch out. He wasn't even blocked. Flipped him in the air. That's one gives you the backache.
Second, third down, goal to go at the 1-yard line. Let's see if Wright slams in straight ahead behind his center, Becker. Wright, the quarterback, right under his center. He does. He went right in behind the quarterback, Becker. Wright for a touchdown, and it makes it Eastern Illinois 20. Northern Colorado 7. The Panthers of Eastern Illinois score on the third play of the second quarter and at the end also of a 54-yard touchdown drive, which began late in the opening period.
It's funny, talking with the coaching staff, they felt for Eastern Illinois that their team really has not gelled until about 2 weeks ago. Now we're seeing, you know, just an explosive offense here.
That touchdown came only just about a minute into the second quarter. Extra point try by DeLong is good. So DeLong has added an extra point after all 3 Eastern Illinois touchdowns. So it's Eastern Illinois 21, Northern Colorado 7. little while ago, we told you about ESPN's fine collegiate basketball coverage. And, of course, they also have some great championship boxing every week to be programmed Saturday night, December the 13th, beginning at 10:30 Eastern Time from Olympic Auditorium in Los Angeles. Two pretty busy small fellas for the WBA Flyweight Champion. And it features the champion, Tae-Sik Kim, who's won 14 of his 15 bouts, 11 of those 14 on KOs. Kim, as I'm sure you know, is from South Korea, against the number one contender in the world from South Africa, Peter Methibula, who's had 14 knockouts. So it's Kim the champion and Methibula the contender from Olympic Auditorium in L.A. for the WBA flyweight title, Saturday night at 10:30, December the 13th. 21-7 here at Eastern Illinois, and the host team is ahead, and Eastern Illinois to kick off. DeLong kicking off, and James for Northern Colorado is right near the goal line. High
short
and not
kick.
Deep at all. Might go out of bounds. No, it's saved by Northern Colorado before it went out of bounds across the 25-yard line. I thought, Terry, they might let it roll out and make Eastern Illinois kick off again. Eight-play drive. It started late in the first quarter and then wrapped itself up early in this quarter. Covered better than 5 minutes. Northern Colorado from its 27. Winslow is a left-handed thrower, and he's ankle-tackled inside the 25-yard line by number 86, Keith Wanowski. Wanowski came up strong and got right to Winslow.
Northern Colorado is going to have to do some blocking up there because they're not giving Winslow any time at all. Even on a rollout, a quarterback shouldn't be pressured that much. There's Wanowski. Good play by the defensive man.
A loss of 3 yards has the ball back at the Bear 24. Northern Colorado getting Lindsay out to the left. That's the open field for this left-handed throwing quarterback, Al Winslow, out of Fort Collins, Colorado. Second and 13. He throws incomplete, way beyond Larry Sage, who's perhaps his favorite receiver. Sage was on the receiving end of 30 passes this year, but he was nowhere near that throw by Winslow. Third down, 13.
I think Winslow on that play was so used to getting pressure, there was no pressure on that play, and he got rid of the ball a little too quick. Rush his throw.
12 minutes, 43 seconds to go in our second quarter. Bright, the deep back in the Northern Colorado eye. Resetting, Sage. The fake to Bright.
Watch it.
And he's dropped back at the 17-yard line for a loss of 7 yards. I tell you, Don Pittman really rushing the quarterback. You'll see him in just a moment. Pittman, number 12.
Pittman's probably their best support man. He's a strong safety, and they blitz a lot. If, you know, if they hold up their tight end, the strong safety's coming. You see Pittman there doing the damage, number 12.
All right, the punt man, Tony Davis, the deep man, Kevin Gray. Gray is at the Eastern Illinois 41-yard line. So once again, Eastern Illinois about to have outstanding field position. Davis punting from the 5. Hangs up there pretty good, and from the 49-yard line, Gray to the 45, Gray to the 40-yard line. Nice return by Kevin Gray from his own territory into Northern Colorado terrain as far as the 39.
Gray's a defensive player, but all the offensive coaches would love to have him as a tailback because he's an exciting runner.
All right, for the first time in the football game, we'll see the alternating Eastern Illinois quarterback, Jeff Christensen. And before we see that, we'll also have on the return a penalty marched off against the Panthers of Eastern Illinois, clipping. So don't mark the ball at the Northern Colorado 39. Put it instead now at the Eastern Illinois 46-yard line. Jeff Christensen, a 190-pound sophomore, number 11. He's the quarterback. He is from Gibson City, Illinois, and handling his first play of the afternoon. Staple trying to fight outside, and he can't. He is dropped at the line of scrimmage by Bob Napton, number 88. Napton proving again today why he's led his team in tackles this year. Christensen only intercepted 10 times out of 194 attempts this year. At one point of the season, this young sophomore threw 51 passes in a row without an interception. Second and 10. 11 minutes, 15 seconds to play in the second quarter. Eastern Illinois ahead, 21-7. First time that Christensen will throw. No, he's not. He came back through a mass of tacklers and was dropped at the 44-yard line, a two-yard loss. Todd Volkert, number 90, put the hit on.
A little surprised, Bill, talking with the Eastern Illinois coaches. They said they were going to throw a lot from the shotgun today, but we have yet to see that, because both of their quarterbacks, Christensen and Wright, are not mobile quarterbacks. They just want them to sit back there in the pocket and throw the ball.
Third down, 12 at the Eastern Illinois 44.
Come on, offense. There's a shotgun.
All right, Wright standing. Or rather, Christensen standing 5 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Hard and down the middle and caught near the 45-yard line. It's the tight end, number 81. Rob Mihalik should be a first down.
Anytime you see a defense, almost a good handle by Christensen there, bad snap. The defense is rolling up on the outside, trying to cover those wide receivers. We got a tight end that's open down the middle. Mihalik comes up about 3 yards short and gets that first down on his own there.
First down at the Northern Colorado 44. Well, the bomb is being thrown downfield.
Uh-oh.
McGee, had he caught the ball, Scott McGee would have had a touchdown.
I mean, that's one of the most gorgeous throws that I've seen so far this year. Christian just laid it in there perfectly. McGee didn't have to break stride. He forgot one thing, though, the ball.
Well, Christensen applauding and say, well, let's try it again. We missed on that one, but let's do it again.
Let's see the tail end of it here. And he's just going in full stride. I mean, the ball just went right through his hand. Great throw. Just one-on-one defensively.
I tell you, Terry, he also did it so confidently and so easily. It was an effortless throw by the sophomore quarterback, Jeff Christensen.
I guess it would have gone for not anyway, a penalty on the play.
Face mask against Eastern Illinois. And the ball now is back at the Eastern Illinois 41-yard line.
That's first down in a bunch now. Pretty close to 28 yards.
Each team now has been assessed a pair of penalties in this first half. First and 25. Out of the shotgun, the inside handoff to Slaughter, the fullback. And Dwayne Hirsch, the defensive right tackle from Holyoke, Colorado, knew exactly what was about to happen. Dwayne Hirsch with the defensive hit, number 78.
One of the plays that they'll run, I'm sure you're sure the folks have seen the Dallas Cowboys run this shotgun here. And very effective. One of the plays, you know, everyone's rushing a passer. That little inside handoff at times can be effective. That time Hirsch read it perfectly.
After the 2 yard loss, it's now second down, 27. Mihalik splits slightly left. Penalty flag down. Christensen with his man Mihalik down the middle and caught near the 47 yard line.
That Mihalik is a load. He catches that ball. He punishes people afterwards.
Terry, it looked like the right side of Northern Colorado's defensive line might have jumped before the snap of the ball. That's what they're calling against Northern Colorado. Now, the play gained some 9 yards. So there's a decision now to be made by the quarterback, Jeff Christensen, and he's asking for assistance from the bench. Do I take the 5-yard penalty and keep the down the same? Do I take the 9-yard gain and run another down off the scoreboard? official is telling him, look, you gain 5 yards with a penalty. You gain 9 yards if you take the down. And they're going to take the penalty and keep the down the same and put the ball at the 44-yard line.
There's Coach Bob Blazy, Northern Colorado. He's done a fine job with that program.
15 years a head coach, and he's won 90 ball games. And he's been on the Northern Colorado campus since 1955. He served 11 years, first of all, as a line coach there. So it's second and 22 from the 44. 8:55 to play in the second quarter. Again, Mahalik's puts out slightly left. Out of that shotgun, Christensen back at the 35 and overthrows number 45, Rod Slaughter, one of his running backs. So we got third down and 22 approaching. East Illinois, most of the year, with fellows like Christensen and the other quarterback right, prefers the pass to the run. Eastern Illinois averaged per game just under 250 yards in the air and averaged only 129 yards a game on the ground. Third and 22. Shotgun formation again. The inside handoff to Little Staple. And he barely manages to fight his way to the line of scrimmage. And Dwayne Hirsch brought him down, and it's a punting situation now dictated for Eastern Illinois. And Don Mansky will come on to do the punting.
I'll tell you, in a couple more plays, we're not going to be able to see Hirsch's number there, number 78. Get a look at him now. He's getting awful muddy.
Well,
Christensen will punt from here. He's their backup punter.
Christensen, not Mansky, is in the ball game, and he's going to do the punting. End over end to the 20-yard line and taken by Pinon, and he steps out of bounds near the 25. All right, fellas. A few punches thrown, and in the process, they dropped a penalty flag. There were some punches thrown right at the point where Pinon was knocked out of bounds inside the 25-yard line. So it's going to cost somebody. I think it's going to cost Eastern Illinois.
I think Eastern Illinois wanted to see the punt return man end up in that puddle down there. Try to give him a little extra push.
Personal foul against Eastern Illinois. And here are the gentlemen who are in charge today. Incidentally, this crew is from the Ohio Valley Conference. Glenn Hassel, Bill Rapp, Bill Smith, Don Pace, Ray Current, and Frank Junk. Gentlemen, we wish you well. All right, Northern Colorado trailing 21-7 and has the ball at its 38-yard line. Bright is the deep back in the I formation. And here's Bright to the 40, to the 44-yard line. Bright travels for 6 yards, and then Rich Brown is on the hit. Second down and 4 from the 44-yard line. Larry Sage to the near side of the field. And there's that Sage fellow in motion.
Fumble.
Winslow has fumbled, and a penalty marker is down. The quarterback, Winslow, began to come back with a snap and then lost the handle, and apparently the Bears have recovered. And they've also been detected with a back in motion.
I'll tell you, Winslow and Peterson, the center, are having a lot of trouble with that snap count. Oh, there you see it right there, pulling guard. Knocked. Either that or center kept the ball. Center sneak.
So a motion call against Northern Colorado, and the step off is to the 39-yard line, where it will be still second down, but now 9 for a first down.
Those things are a nightmare for a head coach. You've gone through the whole season, very successful. There's the first downs, Northern Colorado zip, and Eastern Illinois, nine of them.
Again, the Northern Colorado touchdown was on an intercepted pass that gave them a very early lead. Reigns 45, the upback.
Oh, a little shotgun of their own.
Now they go shotgun with Winslow. Again, he's a left-handed quarterback. He's throwing deep.
Got him.
And overthrows his receiver, number 21, Rick Yeager. Yeager went down the sideline, step for step, with a cornerback, Rich Brown, number 44.
One thing you have to realize when you're a quarterback, you have to keep that ball in the field of play. If you overshoot the guy, no problem. But to throw it out of bounds is, you know, just a wasted throw. That time Yeager had him beat down there.
Third down and nine. 7 minutes, 28 seconds to play in the second quarter. Bill O'Donnell and Terry Hanratty with you from Charleston, Illinois, in this Division II playoff game. Sage going that way. Winslow going that way also, and Bright is to the 45-yard line. Sophomore running back Jim Bright goes for 6 yards, but he winds up 3 yards short of a first down. And that means the Northern Colorado punting situation. Northern Colorado has yet to pick up a first down in this game.
Hey, Bill, if I was Northern Colorado, I think I'd stay in that shotgun, because that time Winslow had an awful lot of time to throw the ball. Such an advantage back there.
Tony Davis on the field to punt. Here's number 10, Kevin Gray, who stands at East Illinois' 20. Davis is back at his 30. Fair catch call made at the 29-yard line. This Eastern Illinois team from 1951 through 1977 had only one winning season. Matter of fact, 3 years ago, Eastern Illinois won only one of 11 games. And then Dr. Darryl Mudra came here, and he really has turned things around. From the 29-yard line, first and 10. The handoff is to Staple, and the little guy finds a little daylight to the 34-yard line. A 5-yard gain. Bob Knapp to the linebacker, hitting Staple.
That's the thing about these small running backs. They get behind these big offensive linemen, and the defense can't find them. That's what Staple, he gets. It was designated to go to the right. He saw nobody there, so he just screwed it off to the left-hand side.
Second down and 5, just barely inside the 35-yard line. Here's Staple. He's to the 40. He's to the 45-yard line for a first down. Staple slipping and sliding, but regaining his balance, keeps his momentum going, an 11-yard gain, and then he's knocked over by Mike Horton, the linebacker, number 53.
I think they really caught Northern Colorado off balance that time, because not many times does Eastern Illinois run the ball twice in a row. I think they were looking for pass there.
First and 10, Eastern Illinois. From the 45-yard line, under the guidance of this sophomore quarterback, Jeff Christensen. Running back, Slaughter, 45, Staple. Caught and then dropped. With his hands on the ball, Scott Weber inside the Northern Colorado 40. And Donnie James was right beside him when he had the ball and then lost it. Incomplete pass on first down.
You got to give Christensen a frustration period at this point, because he's had two nice passes dropped on him.
Again, through the first 3 plays of this second quarter, Chuck Wright, the senior quarterback, had handled the offense. Since that time, it's been Christensen. Second and 10. Straight drop, and then a pass out here to Slaughter, who's at midfield, and then smacked at the 48-yard line. The gain is of 7 yards, and Bob Napton ripped in pretty good to rob Slaughter on the tackle. Third and 3 after the 7-yard gain on the forward pass. Eastern Illinois, in its first 11 games of the year, has averaged 32 points a game. It's ahead right now, 21-7. Christensen, almost, it is intercepted. It's been intercepted near the 45-yard line by Tard Volker. A couple of Northern Colorado players could not make up their mind who would get it. There's also a penalty marker drop after the intercepted pass by Volker.
Well, that's a late marker, Bill.
I think it might be for a clip.
Hey, when you're throwing that ball down the middle, quarterback has to realize, keep it low, keep it into the receiver's stomach, because if you throw it high, then it's just a volleyball game, which that was there.
Personal foul against Eastern Illinois. So is the other one.
You know, what's the throw here? The throw is awful high. But Christensen is pressured a little bit right towards the end here. You see the defensive man coming in. You can see the ball real high, and boy, once it gets up in the air, watch out. And about three Northern Colorado guys had a chance to get it there.
All right, that puts Northern Colorado now in possession at the Eastern Illinois 39-yard line. ...21-7, Northern Colorado trails with less than 5 minutes to go in the second quarter. Now, Winslow so far in the ball game has not had a great deal of success throwing the ball, and Northern Colorado has yet to enjoy a first down. Here is Bright to the 35-yard line. Bright gallops for 4 yards. Now we said Bright, let's change it. That's Copa, 22. Bright wears 32. Copa, 22, is the ball carrier, and now he's going to be replaced by Bright. Second down and 6 at the Eastern Illinois 35. 4 minutes, 10 seconds to go in the second quarter. Northern Colorado's only score on an intercepted pass early in the first quarter. Bright really smacked. Really leveling him was Keith Wanowski, number 86. And also Charlie Krutzinger, number 66.
I tell you, nobody blocks Krutzinger here. You're going to see that Bright's going to get the handoff deep in the backfield. Now watch number 66 come in here. Bye now. Major collision.
2 yard loss. So it's third down and 8. Third down conversions. Northern Colorado has yet to have a successful one. And they go shotgun formation as Winslow is 5 yards deep. Winslow's rushed, but breaks through the pack. And he's to the 30-yard line, but not enough for a first down.
I'll tell you, Bill, I think that was a designed quarterback draw. It looked like it.
Winslow about a yard or two away from a first down.
Tell you, down 21-7 with just under 3 minutes to go. I think I got to go for the first down here to try to get 7 on the board.
2 minutes, 55 seconds to play in the second quarter. East Illinois leading 21-7. Out to the left goes 87 Lindsay. In motion is Sage. Fourth down and 2. Bright for a first down and more. He's to the 20. He's all the way to the 17-yard line. Sophomore tailback Jim Bright, who made second team All-Conference despite missing a good deal of playing time because of various injuries, a clutch run by Bright, and a first down to the 17-yard line.
I think it's, you know, his second team All-Conference. I think it was even amazing that he splits the time with Copa, that he could make second team. That's, you know, the kind of player he is here. Knows where he's going, north and south runner.
First down at the Eastern Illinois 17. 40. It's straight ahead with the fullback, Mike Rains. He gets to the 14-yard line. And Charlie Krutzinger is a busy man again, number 66, on the Eastern Illinois tackle. There's Rains from Westminster, Colorado. Incidentally, several weeks ago, he suffered 4 broken ribs in a game against South Dakota and back playing today for the first time since that injury. second and seven. A minute 55 seconds to go in the opening half. To the 10-yard line is Bright. Dan Pittman stopped his progress. They still need 3 yards for first down. Third down and three.
I tell you, for the people who don't think there's contact in Division II schools, they should hear these pads popping here today.
The clock keeps ticking off seconds. 1 minute, 25 seconds to go on the first half. Northern Colorado trying to cut back into this Eastern Illinois lead, which is 21-7 right now. Winslow, the quarterback, and Northern Colorado at the 10-yard line. Third down and three. To the 9-yard line. A 1-yard gain by Jim Bright. It's still some 2 yards away from a first down. It'll be fourth down and two. A timeout call by Northern Colorado with 56 seconds to play in the half. There is a decision to be made, Terry Hanratty, by Bob Blasey. The decision is, do you go for the first down, do you go for a touchdown pass, or do you go for a field goal perhaps by Kevin Jeldon, your kicking specialist?
Well, it looks like they made the decision there, sending in the kickers.
All right, Kevin Jeldon has tried 16 this year, succeeded on 8 of them. 2 weeks ago, he did have a 43-yarder, so at least on the books now, he's got the range.
The bad part about it is it's tough turf to kick off him. There's a sidewinder kicker, and I'll tell you, they really have a problem when it's muddy out.
All right, Jeldon will be trying one from the 16-yard line, so his attempt will be some 26 yards. Nick Henkowski, a backup quarterback, number 14 right there, is the holder.
I take it back. I thought Jeldon was a sidewinder. He's straight on, so he's got a good shot at this.
26-yard attempt by Jeldon of Northern Colorado. 56 seconds to
bad
go.
Bad snap.
And a very high snap. Now, this is a quarterback running the ball. Henkowski, it's caught at the 15-yard line, and not enough for a first down. Receiver goes to the 10-yard line. There's also a marker drop back near the 20. It was caught by a tight end, Josh Brittle.
Watch the snap here. It's high. I think the holder panicked a little bit here. I think they still could have got it off. He handled the ball cleanly. Being an old quarterback, he wants to get in the action himself. One thing you got to realize when it's a field goal, you're out there by yourself because everybody else thinks you kicked the ball. Everybody wants the ball. Throw it. It was an offensive lineman who caught the ball. Illegal receiver. There you go. There's your penalty.
So in the closing 45 seconds, Eastern Illinois still leading 21-7. After the penalty called against Northern Colorado, it's the Panther ball at the 23. Christensen, number 11, the sophomore quarterback, back in the ball game. Slaughter drives his way to the 27. A 4-yard gain by the fullback Slaughter, and he's met by Todd Volker at the 27-yard line. Clock running, 30 seconds to play in the first half. Second down, six. Clock still moving, 20 seconds. From the shotgun, the inside handoff to the little speedster, and Staple meets a crowd of Northern Colorado tacklers at the 34-yard line, and they are all led by Dwayne Hirsch, number 78. I tell you, Staple, Terry, when he gets the ball, just has one idea. Get outside and try to outrace everybody, and Staple's run also ends the first half. In our Division II playoff game in Charleston, Illinois, the score at halftime is Eastern Illinois 21, Northern Colorado 7.
Hi, I'm Gabe Kaplan, and I'd like to show you cystic fibrosis. This is cystic fibrosis. Respiratory equipment to help a child breathe and equipment to measure that breathing. And this is cystic fibrosis. Laboratory tests seeking better medical care and a cure for CF. And cystic fibrosis is also a lot of medication to aid digestion and fight lung infection. And most of all, this is cystic fibrosis for those who were born with it. Constant daily treatment, repeated hospitalization, interrupted schooling, shortened lives. This is Tommy. He has cystic fibrosis. He needs special care today to give him a chance for tomorrow. Now that you've seen cystic fibrosis, won't you help? Because for kids with CF, time is running out.
We are at halftime in Charleston, Illinois. Bill O'Donnell with Terry Hanratty, and Eastern Illinois leading at halftime 21-7. Terry Hanratty, it did appear shortly after the ball game began that Northern Colorado was going to put up quite a fight. In fact, Northern Colorado, after the second play of the ball game, led 6-0 on Nosler's interception and then his touchdown run. But things have certainly been different since that one play.
Well, they stunned Eastern Illinois early with the interception for the touchdown, put 7 points on the board. But Eastern Illinois is a really high-powered offense, and I think, you know, they got to them with the passing of right end Christensen. They're just putting the points on the board, moving up and down at will.
Now, we did know, of course, that the strength of Eastern Illinois was its passing game. We've seen that already. We also were told that the strength of the Northern Colorado game was its rushing performance, but that has not been a strength.
Oh, two good runners in Chris Copa and
Jim Bright.
Yeah, Jim Bright. But the thing is, you know, Eastern Illinois, one of their big strengths is their defense against the rush. And I look for them, you know, when Northern Colorado went to the shotgun, they weren't that successful, Bill, but they had time to throw the ball. So I think they're going to go in the locker room and say, hey, you know, this is probably the only thing we have to resort to get back in the ball game here.
Terry Hanratty, we did discuss at great length and for good reason, and also discussed it with some of the football players and the coaches prior to game time, the very sloppy field conditions. How much of a factor has the field played in the first half?
I don't think it has at all. I saw very little slipping out there. I think the only thing we're going to see here is with the pass rush of Northern Colorado. I think that's been slowed down. Eastern Illinois has had an awful lot of time to throw the ball, and the quarterbacks have been successful.
All right, at halftime again, it is Eastern Illinois 21, Northern Colorado 7. Back again following this message.
A lot of people think that the Wall Street Journal will help a man get ahead in business. It can. The Wall Street Journal will tell a man every business day what is happening in business, here and everywhere around the world. It can give you information, insights, and facts that you can get nowhere else. The Wall Street Journal has the world's largest staff of business news experts. Their job is to find anything that can affect you, your company, and your future, and report it to you. The Wall Street Journal delivers to you every business day all the business news you need, when you need it. Will that help a businessman get ahead? It can. And a businesswoman. Congratulations, TJ.
Thank you.
It can help you. Subscribe now. Get the Wall Street Journal delivered every business day for 52 weeks for just $63. Call toll-free 800-228-3300. We'll bill you later. That's 52 weeks of the journal, 260 issues for just $63. Phone 800-228-3300 now.
Sports, all sports, and nothing but sports, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. ESPN, your total sports network, brings you the very best in sports programming and the latest scores, news, views, and interviews on SportsCenter, the most comprehensive sports news program on television. Your ticket to total sports is ESPN.
Terry Hanratty, in the first half, again with Eastern Illinois leading the ball game, and not only leading, but really dominating by a score of 21-7. We have seen both of Darryl Mudra's Eastern Illinois quarterbacks for the first quarter, and then a few plays early in the second quarter, the senior Chuck Wright, and then since that point, and for the rest of the second quarter, the sophomore quarterback Jeff Christensen. One by one, let's take them each in order. What about Wright's performance in the first quarter?
Well, I was really impressed, Bill, because he started out with the interception for the touchdown, and that's not a good way to start a game at all. But he came back and he threw the ball down the middle, which impressed me. He showed an awful lot of confidence, and I think of the two, I think he probably played better. But Christensen, on the other hand, he had a couple passes dropped on him. which could have been big gainers. And one could have been a touchdown, but there was also a penalty there, so you have to take that into consideration. But he's shown an awful lot of cool out there, and he has not thrown the ball that much. So the second half, I think he'll throw it a lot more.
Tell you one thing that Christensen did show us, and you just bordered on it with your conversation. Christensen did show us an extremely strong arm, and he also indicated to us that he's not ashamed at all to throw the bomb.
Well, not at all, and he showed a strong arm and a very accurate arm.
So we've seen Wright, we've seen Christensen, and Terry and I both assuming that we will see Wright and Christensen as well in the alternating quarterback scheme of Eastern Illinois in the second half. We're at halftime with the score. Eastern Illinois, 21, Northern Colorado, 7.
Muhammad Ali, have you heard about the special offer from Inside Sports?
No, but I'm sure you're going to tell me about it.
It's an offer even you won't want to pass up. You get 8 issues of Inside Sports for only $12, 25% off the regular subscription price.
That's nice, but how many issues am I going to be?
Ali, what's the difference? Every issue of Inside Sports is loaded with the kind of inside information sports fans are dying to know about.
But when it comes to Ali, they don't get enough.
Well, maybe so, but when it comes to football, baseball, basketball, and hockey, Inside Sports really digs deep to tell you what's going on behind the scenes. They go inside the locker room, the players' homes, even inside the players' heads.
When they don't have Ali, they're not as inside as they could be.
They're as inside as anyone can be. Look at this football issue. There's enough inside information here to keep you reading for months, and Inside Sports really covers the story in depth. Comprehensive articles that tell you things about your favorite athletes that even their teammates don't know. And the people who write for Inside Sports, like Pete Axthelm, Vic Ziegel, and Roy Blunt, are some of the best in the business.
That's what I was the night I fought Foreman, the night I fought Frazier, the night I fought Liston.
Ali, will you stop looking back? Look ahead to all the fascinating things you're going to find out in the upcoming issues of Inside Sports. Do you know for only $12, you're going to get $1 million worth of information you can't get anywhere else?
$1 million? I wouldn't even put on an exhibition for that.
Well, then you know how little $12 is, Ali. And don't forget, Inside Sports hasn't ignored you, so you could say something nice.
Inside Sports is the greatest, but not of all times. How about that? Mel?
So call toll-free 1-800-453-9000 to get 8 issues of Inside Sports coming to you at the special price of only $12, 25% off the regular subscription price. That's 1-800-453-9000. It's a free call and major credit cards are accepted.
Due to the conditions of the playing field here at Charleston, Illinois, the 198-member-strong Eastern Illinois marching band is unable to entertain on the playing field, but it is entertaining right now on the running track here at O'Brien Stadium. This Eastern Illinois band, directed by Mr. Harold Hillier, who's in his 9th year here at Eastern Illinois, the drum majors, Paul Beal, Tom Cravens, and Lynn Pearson, and let's tune in now on Chicago. entertained in the background. We're going to be entertained conversationally by the gentleman to our left, the events coordinator of the NCAA, and for this event, Dennis Pope, all the way from Shawnee Mission, Kansas. Dennis, Eastern Illinois, of course, makes preparations for this game as the host school. But what do you and the NCAA do for this event? Pardon me, the NCAA.
Well, in addition to this game, we have three other games today, so we've been busy working with the host institutions at the other three sites. And prior to that, though, we were just busy selecting the eight teams and making sure we had the top eight teams in Division II. And we feel this year that the top, or these teams are the top teams, and we have a well-balanced field, and we'll have a good football championship.
Dennis, I'm sure that after the heavy downpour of snow here on Wednesday night and Thursday, there was a great deal of concern about the playing field. There was a great deal of concern today, but really things have gone fairly well.
Well, we're pleased. Obviously, there's nothing you can do about the heavy snowfall we had here, and the 8 inches that fell on Thanksgiving Day really played havoc with the field. They had it in great shape, had it painted, and had it in very good shape. And what happened is yesterday morning when they started to take the snow off, it started to melt, and therefore the ground below got very muddy, and they took a good layer of the grass off, and we had to start all over again and prepare the field. And they've done a good job, and it's just something that's part of the game. It's for many football fans, they don't see muddy football fields anymore, so it's kind of a rarity for some of our fans.
Dennis, preparing for what's ahead, and let's take it step by step and school by school. If Northern Colorado should come back in the second half and win this football game, then what takes place for Northern Colorado?
Well, the winner of this game will play the winner of the Virginia Union North Alabama game, which is being played right now in Florence, Alabama. And there are many things that could happen, but let's just say if Northern Colorado should win, they would have the first option to host the semifinal contest next Saturday. If North Alabama should win, they still could have an opportunity. Virginia Union could still have an opportunity. There are many factors. Eastern Illinois probably would have had a great opportunity. However, the field conditions, we'll have to take a look at the end of this game, see if it's playable, try to determine what can be done to make it playable, and then we'll just have to make a decision. We will have a conference call to determine its late.
So before the weather kind of hit this part of Illinois the other night, had Eastern Illinois won, there was no question it would be played here, but now there is that question.
I think that, yes, that's correct. Without a doubt, they probably would have been the site. However, with the condition of the field, we want the best possible playing condition, and that's what the committee will have to decide.
Well, that's wise, and that's the way it should be. And Dennis Pope, thanks for joining us here at halftime. Back with the second half after this message.
The recipe calls for 1 cup of brown sugar. But since you love brown sugar, you naturally add 2. And then there's the raisins. The only problem is getting the batter into the oven before you eat it all. Our families help us learn more about the world we live in. Parents offer their children the knowledge of experience and love, because love is a family affair. A message of love and concern from Boys Town.
Get the NFL story line by line, live each Thursday evening at 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific Time. Hi, I'm Chris Berman, inviting you to join me as I referee the Fearless Predictions of veteran pros Terry Hanratty and Paul McGuire. We'll give you up-to-date information on the teams, the players, and, of course, the point spreads. The NFL story line by line, exclusively on ESPN.
CAA basketball on ESPN, Stanford at Marquette, Sunday, December 7th, 8 p.m. Eastern Time, on your Total Sports Network.
Times Eastern Illinois dominating Northern Colorado to the tune of 21-7, and for the most part Eastern Illinois also dominating Northern Colorado in first downs, in passing, in rushing, in practically, Terry Hanratty, every department.
Well, it's, just look down the sheet there, go to the bottom line where it says total yards 175-18. I mean, it's a surprise to have 7 points on the board with only 18 total yards.
And there's also an interesting differential in the passing department. Northern Colorado has thrown the ball only twice. It's left-handed quarterback Al Winslow, 0-2. And between Chuck Wright, the senior quarterback, and the sophomore quarterback Jeff Christensen, combined 9-15. Between those two quarterbacks, a total offensively of 175 yards to only 18 for Northern Colorado. A 2-touchdown lead for the Panthers of Eastern Illinois. And they will also have the kickoff chores from left to right.
Good picture of Chuck Wright on the sideline warming up, getting ready for this third quarter.